Mr. Gruber, I've been accused that I'm going to berate you or something, and I hope that you won't feel that way when I get done. But night before last, I was at the Kennedy Center Honors, where they honored Tom Hanks, famously Forrest Gump, the ultimate in successful stupid man. Are you stupid?
I don't think so, no.
Does MIT employ stupid people?
Not to my knowledge.
Okay. So you're a smart man who said some, as the ranking member said, some really stupid things, and you said the same. Is that correct?
The comments I made were really inexcusable.
Okay. And leave aside the political observations, but you did say in your the video we played, and everyone else has seen, I think, parts of it, you did say that, in fact, if people knew the whole truth, they wouldn't have voted for this, that in fact the direction you were going, the reality, and specifically I want to talk, because Mr. Goldman's a poster child for this. He has a silver plan that is relatively inexpensive. If it was subsidized, it'd be even cheaper. But the shifting of some people to pay more than they previously did, because remember, health care went up in price. So for Mr. Goldman to get a reduction, somebody else got not only an increase, but an increase to offset his decrease. That was what you were talking about. So isn't it true that, in fact, between the taxes and increases for some, that's part of the plan to reduce for people like Mr. Goldman?
First of all, I made a critical mistake in trying to conjecture with a tone of expertise.
Yeah, no, but you're an expert on the analysis of the numbers and where the cost shifting goes in your microeconomic analysis. And I'm asking you, as Dr. Gruber, a smart man, a smart man at a great institution that has collected over over $4 million in various fees and so on. Your analysis, isn't it true that in order for Mr. Goldman to get his reduction, and he's very happy about it, that in fact there was cost shifting, including those so-called Cadillac plans. Isn't that true?
The Affordable Care Act set up insurance exchanges which pooled risks for the healthy and the less healthy. On average, when you account for the tax credits individuals received, people are paying less for health insurance than they
would. I'm a taxpayer, Mr. Gruber. Trust me, people are not paying less. People like me are paying more for those because taxes are, in fact, a cost that's paid. Total cost did not go down. Cost shifting occurred in your model. Isn't that true?
The amount that individuals have to pay for health insurance, on average, fell in my model.
Well, but it didn't fall in reality. Now, let me just ask one question, and this may be the tougher question for you. You said in these video comments that essentially you had to deceive in order to get this passed. Your models, the $4 million plus dollars that you and MIT received, including hundreds of thousands of dollars personally, to develop and to provide those models, if deception was part of the process by your own statements, why should we believe your analysis? Why should we not demand to go into the microeconomic analysis and find out whether, if, in fact, the $4 million in services you delivered were accurate or whether the books were cooked?
First of all, the amount of money to which you refer has been greatly overstated. It refers to grants that were received by research institutions and others, which I received a small fraction. Second of all, no one has ever questioned the quality or integrity of the modeling. The fact I made
Mr. Gruber, I'm questioning it in light of your statements, and that's why I'm asking. Shouldn't we question or at least have independent analysis of the numbers you delivered before, actually to Massachusetts for that matter too, but to the federal government based on your statements that in fact if people knew the truth they wouldn't, and that there was a deception in your own thing? And it's all I want to go to the ranking member, but is there any reason that you would not approve the idea that there should be independent validation of the numbers you used in light of the statements that we've seen you made?
I think that the quality of my numbers should not be reflected by comments I made where I was conjecturing outside my area of expertise. At the same time, my modeling has always been very transparent. I've posted information about my model, and I'm happy to ask questions about the model, answer questions about the model and how it works.
Thank you. I hope that this committee and the next Congress will insist that there be an independent analysis of whether, in that fact, that model would stand the scrutiny of an audit. With that.